an auto-populator wonderfulness will pop down underneath and it will suggest keywords for you. So that would be where I would go to make sure that I have really nailed the most obvious searches. You need to be taking note of this because these are keywords that work really well for your shop. And a lot of people just start whole new keyword research each time they're listing something new.
Welcome to the Handmade Bosses Show. I'm Steph, and my mission is to help you start, run, and scale an online handmade business and build a creative life you love. So, bosses, let's help you get your amazing products out there and get the sales you deserve.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the Handmade Bosses Show, your one-stop shop to turn your passion into profit. So today I'm going to be talking about the two free places that you need to be looking to find keywords for your Etsy listings. So we all want to find the best keywords for our listing, but here's the thing, and it is a bit of a hard truth to swallow, is that there is no such thing as perfect keywords. There is literally no such thing. It's kind of like saying there's like such a thing as the perfect car, right? It depends on like the person buying the car, what they want to use it for. It's kind of like comparing a boat to a car. They both do completely different things, right? So there is no such thing as perfect keywords. So when I get questions in the Facebook group, and if you don't know, that will be around this video episode somewhere, I do get questions that say, how do I find really good keywords, or how do I do really good SEO? And that's kind of the wrong question to ask. The right question should be, where do I start looking to find keywords that work for me, my business, and my target market? Okay, so just really want to reframe that, flip the script so that you know the right questions to be asking yourself. So the two places that if I had to completely start again and I had to wipe all of my Etsy listings off the face of the planet, the two number one places would be the Etsy search bar and my own stats. I'm gonna be going into each one of those. So, the Etsy search bar is honestly the place that you should be double checking or even finding keywords. So when you go onto Etsy and you start typing something in the bar, an auto-populator wonderfulness will pop down underneath and it will suggest keywords for you. Now, if you are doing product research, if you just go to the Etsy search bar and simply put your cursor in and click it, it will auto-populate loads of really popular searches happening right now. So just a little tip for you. But if you start to type something, it will again like auto suggest other searches that people are using. It's a bit like when you go into Google and you start typing in what is, and then it auto populates all these random things. It's kind of the same thing as that, right? So that would be where I would go to make sure that I have really nailed the most obvious searches. So again, let's use my favorite example, a gold heart locket necklace. If you go onto Etsy and type in gold heart, it will pop down with gold heart necklace, gold heart locket necklace, gold heart keepsake, gold heart jewelry, right? And that is searches that you need to be taking a note of, because at the end of the day, it's all good using other SEO tools like E-Rank, Marmalade, but at the end of the day, guys, you need to be doing keyword research on the platform that you are researching it for, because they have access to API and information that these other tools don't. So although I love E-Rank and that is my favorite tool to use, it's not just because it gives me ideas. I just want to really be clear about that. Ideas, not what keywords I should be using for my listings, okay? So although I do love tools, I really think that the Etsy search bar is the number one place that you should be looking. Now, in the Handmade Bosses Success Academy, and the link to learn more about that will be around here somewhere, probably underneath this episode. Although we do teach you in depth how to do SEO research and how to find keywords that will work for your products and your target market and your business, here's another free little bit of advice for you.
We have been having some great conversations so far on today's episode, but I've got something even more special for you. You know what it takes to be shown on page one on Etsy, right? Yep, you guessed it, increasing your conversion rate. My three-step framework to skyrocket your Etsy conversion rate is my signature free masterclass. And boss, I'm saving a spot for you. Learn how to increase your conversion rate in three easy steps, as well as the top three mistakes I see Etsy shops make on a daily basis. Sign up in the show notes or head to handmadebosses.com/conversion. That's handmadebosses.com/conversion to claim your spot. Now let's get back to the episode, and I can't wait to see you there, boss.
When you're going on the Etsy search bar, try just pressing enter and seeing what is coming up. If you're typing in like something really vague, like gold heart, you're going to be coming up with all sorts of really weird things, right? I mean, if you don't believe me, just go and try it. I'll wait, because it's really weird. But if you're looking for a gold heart necklace, using that keyword phrase is not going to do anything for you. In fact, the conversion rate for that is going to be like 0.00001. So when you are doing your SEO research, right, just have a little gander through the search results and see if you fit in with any of those products. Chances are, if you don't and you're like, I don't really fit in here, it's like walking into a party and you're like, I don't belong here, right? Chances are that if you're thinking that, then that's not the right search for you, okay? So it's a bit of like competition research as well. The second place I would be looking is your own stats. Did you know that you can go onto the little settings cog at the bottom right-hand side of your listings and look at individual listing stats? Bosses, if you are listing something similar to another listing that you have already, you need to be taking note of this, because these are keywords that work really well for your shop. And a lot of people just start whole new keyword research each time they're listing something new, and you are wasting your time, because boss, if these keywords are working well for a listing in your shop with your target market and you're not using them, you're missing out on absolute gold. So something that I would suggest for you to do is to go and watch the episode where I talk about duplicating listings, because that's going to be really helpful for you. But really, honestly, if you are not using keywords that people have already searched to find your items, you are leaving money on the table. So boss, I really hope that you enjoyed this episode of The Handmade Bosses Show. If you're watching on YouTube, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, leave me a comment, send a little chat to me. I get lonely sometimes doing this in my office. If you are listening on the podcast, then guys, please leave a review. It would be so helpful for us. And send me a DM at Handmade Bosses. Tell me, are you ready to dominate Etsy? Are you ready to get more sales in your Etsy shop? I'd love to start a conversation with you. But for now, guys, I will catch you in the next episode of The Handmade Bosses Show. Bye, everyone.
We really hope you enjoyed today's episode. Don't forget to check the show notes for some more helpful links, and also a link to our website as well. Also, you can watch the video version of this over on our YouTube channel. Don't forget to get your free spot on our masterclass, the three-step framework to skyrocket your Etsy conversion rate, at handmadebosses.com/conversion. That's handmadebosses.com/conversion. We would also love it if you could leave us a review on iTunes, as it really helps us to reach more bosses in need. Subscribe to the show, and we will see you on the next episode.